Welcome back to a new video, and in today's video I will be building three houses for three of the nine wood types in Minecraft. I will be building a house for every wood type, but that will be broken up into three videos. This is part one of a three-part series. Each part I will build three houses, starting with part one, which will consist of the oak house, the spruce house, and the birch house. Then it will go up the list, etc. Eventually ending with three parts. All parts will be linked in the description below once they have been released, and the playlist of all three parts once they all come out will be in a playlist on the channel afterward. And so if you would like to binge that and watch them all, that would be good. And the reason that I didn't put them all in one video is because that video would be like an hour and a half. It would be pretty bad. Because this video, which only has like three houses in it, is already running kind of long. Longer than my last video. So, yeah, we'll try to keep it a little bit shorter in the last couple. Try and maybe speed up the time lapse a little bit. But anyway, let's move on to the oak house.
So, guys, this house, I started out by creating a little bit of a platform for the house to go on. Since I wanted this house to be set in the plain, since it's been out of oak wood, I didn't make the hill that I had it on too high. And I started mapping out to like the general like area of the house. I didn't go for a too crazy shape with this one. I just kind of wanted it to be like a rectangle. You see me adding on a little deck right there too. Yep, and so I just added like a second floor on there. You see that? I'm just mapping it out with those oak logs, and then filling it in with like a texture of the stripped and the regular. I decided to do a slab roof with this house, and I believe that's the fully oxidized copper. I believe that's what it's called for the roof. You see me in the chimney. I decided andesite. I thought about like doing stone, but I felt like andesite works better with the oak and like green theme. I feel like it just looks a little bit better. You see me adding some windows now too, and some window cells underneath them. I got the window sills and the window like the shutters from mods. So yeah, but we'll get a better look at those when the time lapse is over. But yeah, and I added a little bit of shrubbery. Like I had some mosses around. I just bone milled like all around, and I feel like it turned out really good. Also added like a pathway up to the deck, made out of like some stone and coarse dirt, and I added like some flower bushes into bushes. I think now you can see me adding in a oak tree outside of the house. I feel like it looks a lot better right now than it does at the end. Anyway, let's check it out.
And now I'm here to show off the first house. This is the oak house. And I feel like this house actually turned out really well. Did turn on the whatever this is, like the leaves that bunch out more, picture pack for the showing off. I think I'll do that for every house, but yeah, this is really nice. Like I feel like I've made better oak trees in the past, and I just kind of wanted to throw an oak tree in here, but yeah, I'm not sure. It is fine. It's not bad. But if we come with this pathway, and show off the interior. So we get this nice hallway right here. We can go into the kitchen area. There are bats in here still. Sorry, guys. We'll go grab a sword. But anyway, so we get the nice kitchen here with some nice kitchen cabinets. sink with a faucet that you can actually turn, some like goblets, some chairs, and then the kitchen table, some dining room. We can go over here, and this is the bathroom. And over here we have a nice bath and a, two faucets again. We have a nice sink with another faucet and a toilet. And then we can come over here, and this is an office, so we can sit down in the chair and we can do some writing with a pot of coffee and a lamp. We got a nice bookshelf and a little like chair and table if you want to do some reading. Sorry guys, I don't know what that was. But anyway, we have the this is like a coat closet or storage closet in here. But just, I had some extra space and I'm like, oh, I'll throw something in here. Now let's go to the second floor, and in here we have a nice bed. We just used some cyan beds and a nice dish and drawers. I just kind of used bare minimum. I just kind of got lazy up on the second floor because I gotta make all these houses. So he's got another drawers, another bed, and some shelves. But yeah, guys, I think this turned out pretty well. Like if we take a look around this house, like it's pretty good in size. Like it's pretty cool. But yeah, guys, I think this turned out pretty well. It's a good oak house, and yeah, we'll remove this off of here, and now we'll move on to these.
Alright, so for this spruce house, I decided to do more of like this big old mountain hill thing for the base of the house, because I wanted to do more of a medieval theme. I thought that'd be cooler, so you can see me adding the gravel and the sand, creating like a naturally sloping pathway up the mountain. Now you see me like texturing it with the stone and the grass. And then you're about to see me like paint the way up the hill with like grass and coarse dirt and all that. Ponzel and stuff to make it look like all like a pathway and stuff. And then you're about to see me there's me adding some like some rocks into the path. Then you see me planning out like parts of the house. I did decide to add like a tower onto this house because I thought that matched well with the medieval theme. I did go for more of a weird shape to this house, way weirder than the other one, because the other one was just a rectangle and this is like real on, and it's got a tower, which I feel like it's just like on brand for the medieval theme. So I feel like that goes real well. Like, now you can see me adding the base of the house with like some pictures of some stones and stuff. Now I'm making it like some spruce and some dark oak, using a mix of both to make it good. But anyway, this is only part one of the time lapse, but part two timed out, so see ya.
So guys, I thought we could take a look at the house. I know that the recording timed out during the second part of the recording, but yeah guys, this is the spruce house. I know it's kind of drastically changed from the last time you guys saw it, because we hadn't even done any of the rooms the last time like the recording was working. I'm really sorry about that, by the way guys, but yeah, I feel like it turned out pretty interesting. I don't know if I really like some of the bits of it. If I did it again, I would definitely change quite a bit. Like, I'm not a big fan of this orange roof. And I don't know. It's something. It definitely feels more castle-y. And this feels more medieval house-y than castle-y. I feel like it's bad some of this, but I do like this overall structure. I do like the main tower bit in the middle. I do like this little thing with like the entrance with the doors. I have not done the interior yet. That's basically, I just wanted to give you guys an overview of this, and I was gonna do a quick
quick cut, and then we'll do the interior. But yeah, I'm basically gonna show you guys. We added the chimney. I think, I don't know, this chimney feels a little bit small for this house because it just feels so big. But I'm not sure. It's not too terribly more. It's not too terribly bigger than this house. That house, like the oak house. I think it's just like a different shape to this, which is basically just a basic rectangle, while this is like more intricate. Yeah. I don't know. We got all sorts of types of trees, and this is like spruce leaves still. But it's just multicolored, and I feel like that adds a nice touch. It makes it add a lot of color. And this is a lot. This is a pretty colorful build for being in like a dark spruce forest. But yeah, I'm really a fan. I do really like how this like slopes into here, and so you got like the mountainside kind of moves in toward the slope of the path that just like winds up here. And it just feels really natural. I really like it. But yeah, let's do a quick snap of my fingers, and we will be the interior will be done. 3, 2, 1.
And now we are here. Now I have fully done the interior. Gosh dang, I gotta stop building these giant houses, because the interiors are very hefty. I know I just walked into here and there's basically nothing, but you'll see. But anyway, this is just like an entrance room. We got a table, we got a nice plant. We walk up here, got an island in the kitchen area. It's not nothing too crazy, but you just got a few decorations, a few cabinets, some chairs that you can see at the table. You got a bedroom right off here, and you got a desk, some shelves. There are still bats, because of course. You got a bed, nightstand, and some windows, and this is the fireplace from the chimney that I added. Over here. Yeah, I tiled this and everything. We'll go down this hallway real quick, and this will lead us to the bathroom. And we got a nice sink in here with some sea pickles, meant to represent like some bottles of something, and like a bathtub / shower. But yes, we got a nice armchair, a bookshelf that we can walk up here, and now we're in the sort of attic area. And right here, we got a nice little window and some boxes. It's kind of a storage area. We got a nice little carpet, a rug, and a little, maybe you can do some reading in here or something, or do some writing. There's a big window. You can look out the window. And then you got a table and chair and some shelves. I'm sort of like a chandelier in here with the chains and the lanterns. But yeah, this house is not as big as the other one, but I feel like it's still still fairly big. But yeah, this it's a pretty nice house. It's kind of weird looking, and I'm in some spots I would definitely change if I made this again. But yeah, I do really like the multicolored trees. Those are really fun with the spruce. But yeah, now let's move on to the birch. Let's see if we can remove this wood off the list. Now we'll grab the birch. Used right now.
For this one, I decided to do like sort of a big flat area on only like one block. And it might look really, really big right now. The grass area that I had, well, I did change it later off camera. So once we get to the viewing of the interior, it'll be changed because it looks a little bit crazy right now. But anyway, I decided to go for a mix of like tuff and andesite as like the stone block and the birch. Here's the birch house. And I wanted to go for more of a modern design, since each house has had its own kind of theme or design. Like the medieval house was the spruce, and the oak house was sort of a suburban farm. The birch is sort of a modern house, but yeah. I went for an odd shape with this one and just tried to do all sorts of fun, like, modern techniques because I didn't get to use it in the other houses, and I just usually don't build in this style very often. But anyway, I really ended up liking, like, the texture with the tuff and the andesite. I thought it looked really nice, and it's something that I really haven't used before. Anyway, we got kind of a weird angle. Well, there we go. Now we can see that the driveway and the pathway. And I'm adding in some of the windows right now, and there's also a flower garden outside. Now let's take a look inside. But there's also a tree right there too.
Guys, so this is the final house in this video. There will be more in part 2, and then finally part 3. But this is the birch house. Here's a shot of the interior. Then we'll take a quick look at the outside before. So we have a table right here. And since this house is kind of smaller, I decided to add in, this is sort of a dinner table, and this is a couch. And like, hypothetically, you could like pull up a chair or something else, but that's for now. We got some cabinets up here. Got some cabinets down here, a sink. Got with cookies, because I saw that would be cool. It's from the supplementaries mod. Right here is the bathroom. I feel like this looks pretty nice. I'll get the mirror, which I don't think looks very good. This is like an iron block from the chisel mod. I don't know. It looks fine, but I don't know. Then here we got the shower. Oh, shoot. And you can just, it's pretty small. I don't know if I like how I added the window there right to the outside. It looks kind of weird, but I'm just using the space. But anyway, a nice countertop where you can do like some cooking or some baking or whatever. Got a nice modern shelf because it's sort of a modern house. If you guys didn't see like in the time lapse, we got a lamp here on the table. Got a nice, chair, another modern chair. In the same style as the couch over there. Got some, these are still birch leaves, but it's just like a darker color because I feel like they went better with the house on the inside. We got a back door that leads to that path on the outside, the front. Show the garage real quick. So this is the garage. Just added like some stuff where you would have different tools and stuff if you want to work on like some work. And there is this driveway leads right out. And I love the garage door. This is from that Macaw's doors, I believe. And like they also have doors like this. Like this door where they just have like versions of the door. But the versions of like birch doors, but have the dark oak pattern or something like that. But it applies to all doors. And they also just have like garage door, which is pretty cool. I like that. But anyway, now we'll go ahead and go upstairs. I tried to go for a different feel than the downstairs. It's a little bit more light and bright, a little bit more nice. Got a nice table. You can do like some writing, or you can just like talk to people. Some reading, there's a big window, so it's pretty nice. Or you could use that could function as a dining table too. This is a bedroom, it's kind of dark and dingy, but I just kind of had what I had to work with because I didn't add in a window. Kind of wish I did, but just didn't. There's a desk here. If I probably would have remade this house, I probably would have had a window. But we got a lamp here. Got a nice bed, which is like a modern design. And two shelves with one that has like a little plant on it. And I thought that was pretty nice. But yeah, guys, we'll take a quick look from the outside and then I will cut to the intro. But yeah, this nice little flower garden, I guess. Yeah, outside the house, I feel like it looks nice and modern. It looks pretty nice. And it's a nice like pop of color from the rest of the house. Like I was going off an image for this house, but I just added that in. That's not even in the house. I just decided it'd be fun. There's a path that like, once we saw. Yeah, this leads to the back door. Yeah, if I made this house again, probably add more windows. That's one of the main things I would add. I don't think I would change too much. Just basically add some more windows and maybe make it a bit bigger. And here is the birch tree outside. I don't really like this. If I probably made the house, I'd probably make some of those, like, where I just use the fence. It's sort of like they use the leaves, but it's just like. There's sort of trees like that, where it's just like a fence, and then surrounded it is like a little bit of leaves. Yeah, since those trees, I feel like would look a little bit more better with this modern style, but it's fine. I did want to incorporate the birch bark color somewhere into the build, since I did that on the other houses. So I not only have just the birch, plank, but I also have the stripped birch planks and the birch, like, or bark plank, birch bark wood. Anyway, guys, let's. So guys, now you guys have seen those three houses for episode one. Hope you enjoyed. Leave a like and subscribe if you want to see more like this. Kind of planning to make part one and or part two and part three very soon. I might switch it up and do another video in between some of the weeks, but yeah, that's the plan. That'll be coming out soon. All right, goodbye.